Hi everyone, welcome to my sharing on how to build a real Starship Enterprise. Now you have to see what I already covered the power source from my previous video, part 1. So now I'm going to go to part 2, where it's the exterior covering of the and the structures of the Starship Enterprise outer covering. So what metal alloy is used in spacecraft in NASA? Aluminium and aluminium composite. So titanium alloys can also strengthen the body of the ship. So the space shuttle has very special thermal protection tiles which help it survive heat of re-entry. They are made of certain ceramic composite, which is the bottom of the tiles are made from a carbon composite to provide for most of the heat protection. So it's made of many layers of metal, the different combination of metals. They have also special protection tiles, besides having the aluminium alloy, they have a special protection tile. So this is how the Starship Enterprise will be like. And the other material which was mentioned was called Kevlar. One of the materials that is able to fit the build is Kevlar. Kevlar, a material used in bulletproof vests and armor, is an incredibly lightweight and strong material, making it perfect for space travel. In addition to its high strength, Kevlar is also making incredibly resistant to temperature changes, making it ideal for orbiting structures that move in and out of the sun direct heat as they orbit the Earth. Kevlar toughness and durability also makes it ideal for protecting artificial satellites from dangerous orbital debris. So Kevlar is one of them. This is aluminium. They talk about one of the main thing is the International Space Station. In order to protect the window from impact, the window is made with glass thicker than panes of glasses on Earth and often with twice as many panes. However, additional aluminium shutters guarantee the safety of the astronauts within. What's an aluminium shutter? Let's check it out. What is an aluminium shutter? Let's go to Google and check out. What is an aluminium shutter? Let's go to the image. Also, I think this is the shutter. So to have the shutter, it actually will strengthen the glass pane. So I think in a Starship Enterprise, you need to have a glass pane, wall also, because you need to actually see what's outside of the surroundings of your spaceship. So you definitely need a glass pane, a very strong glass which is very resistant to high temperatures, low temperatures, and very strong. So this is how it's going to be like. And so what do you think, material do you think is good? Because I don't study material science, but they do say titanium do increase the strength. So I think maybe the aluminium alloy can have a titanium in it to make it strong, make it even stronger. And titanium is used in space and airplanes on Earth. I mean, they travel in the airplanes within Earth. But then if it's in space, perhaps titanium can strengthen it. So what other ideas? I don't know. I think that the real Starship Enterprise have this electromagnetic field around the shields. See? So how is it going to have the shields around it? So this is what I'm going to also going to find out, how they have the invisible shield with all these materials, whether it can fit it. So this is about the material of this. So it has to be strong, sturdy. It has to be also taking high temperatures. And temperature difference must be, you can take high different temperature distance in the space. So this how you're gonna have the these are two materials, Kevlar or aluminium alloy. So these are the two materials. But currently NASA is using aluminium alloy. So it would be good also to have aluminium alloy. But I was also thinking of like is to reduce the cost and to do a prototype testing, we do a small version of the Starship Enterprise, like as big as a apartment or a big of a size of a few apartments instead of having a big size, very like big warship, because warship size of the Starship Enterprise, you can have a small mini version that actually works. Then you can actually expand the size of it, so that will be great. So without further ado, I will just end this sharing, and then please leave your comments on what do you think is a good material for this Starship Enterprise, and please subscribe to my channel for more updates. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.